is Gabriel Ramos. I'm a visual artist originally from Puerto Rico, but I currently live and work in the Tampa Bay area. In the recent years, a lot of my work has revolved around the idea of drawing. A lot of the inspiration comes from my childhood memories, as well as my experiences in the US. I like to explore ideas of potentiality, humor, and failure in my work, from linear wire drawings that go into space to really traditional ways of making drawings with ink on paper to graphite or charcoal. On this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to do a rubbing drawing technique, which means that you're gonna use a surface or a texture or an item, and then you're gonna place it underneath the paper, and you're gonna use either charcoal, graphite, or any kind of dry media and rub it against the paper to bring that information into the drawing. Some of the materials that we're gonna use for this tutorial are a piece of paper, primarily something not too thick. Drawing paper works best. Also, we're gonna determine what kind of texture we're gonna use. I'm using these cutouts out of a material, it's a fabric material called buckram, which is hat making material. And it has a lot of texture, and the fibers are gonna show through the paper once I start, you know, creating the drawing. So I make sure that they're placed. I tape them so they don't move. The neat thing about the tape is that it is gonna show, and I'm planning on to that being part of my composition. So if you don't want that, make sure to attach your texture either in a way that it's underneath, or if you're using an item that's heavy, or basically a surface that's already in place. For my drawing media, I am using a graphite, a soft graphite. I believe it's 4B. And basically, we're gonna start slowly rubbing onto the paper to start bringing that information. What I like to do is to slowly build up the drawing instead of going really crazy on it. That way, I have a little bit of control over the final result. Right now, I'm going over the contours of the shapes underneath the paper to make sure they come through. I want to really bring that information, and I want to make sure it shows and it fills the composition the way I want it. As you can see, I am going over the contours of the shapes to create a sense of volume. I am, you know, making some areas darker, leaving some areas lighter to make sure it gives the illusion of volume and it doesn't feel flat. Even though, you know, the overall aspect of a rubbing, it's a flat image. Once you feel you have an even coat in the designated areas for your drawing, you want to make sure to clean some of the areas if you're, you know, you have unwanted marks or things that you were not happy about. In my case, I'm leaving it as it is. I like some of the roughness of the marks, and I also like some of the negative space around it being a little bit filled with value. But if you want to do that, you can use the eraser, or you can use the kneaded eraser to clean some of that, or to lighten some of the areas to kind of create a sense of volume. For our final step, we're gonna make sure that our drawing is cleaned, and we're gonna basically spray the drawing with a workable fixative spray. We wanna do this in a well-ventilated space, and we wanna do even coats throughout the whole drawing. Make sure to read the instructions in the bottle. Depending on the brand, you know, your drawing might require several coats, so make sure to read the instructions and follow the directions. So here's the final result. I am quite happy how it turned out. Again, this is a really easy technique, but you can get really complex and really interesting results with it. So don't be afraid of using it as either a base of your drawing, or you can use it as your way of making, you know, different kind of drawings with using different surfaces and textures and items. You know, you have endless possibilities for this technique. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. If you want to know a little bit more about my work, you can go onto my website, gbramos.com, or follow me on any kind of social media platform at gbramosart. And thank you for watching.